This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning,
good morning, ma'am.
How are you all?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Fine, ma'am.
Fine, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Only 65 participants are there. Where are others? Already 10, 1. So we'll start the class.
Yes, ma'am.
So, yes, you know, ma'am. My name is class teacher, this person, Deepa, and I'll be handling your subject, that is pharmaceutical analysis. How many subjects you have in your person?
Four, ma'am. Ma'am.
Four,
ma'am.
Five, ma'am.
Four.
It's
five.
Totally five subjects. Four are university exams, and the one is on university exam where you'll be writing under college. So, but all these will be added in your mass card. So, for all the five subjects, you'll have the credit points in your mass card. So, which is the first subject? Anatomy and physiology part one is your first subject where you have both theory and practical. Second subject is pharmaceutical analysis. So here also you have theory and practical. Third subject is pharmaceutical.
Your voice is not audible, ma'am.
Ma'am, your voice is lagging.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible. Yes, ma'am.
All of you mute yourself, then it will be audible. So other than this five subject, we'll be having those who have not studied either biology or mathematics in their 12th standard or PUC or intermediate. They need to study remedial biology or remedial mathematics. So if you others are interested, if you want to attend, you need to write exams for that. You'll be having sessionals, you'll be having final exams, everything for that also. It's not just a choice. So for who have not taken the subjects, for them it is compulsory. Attendance, everything will be recorded. So weekly, 2 hours will be there for remedial maths and remedial biology. Other than that, the remaining five subjects, four are, that is human anatomy and physiology, pharmaceutical analysis, pharmaceutics, and pharmaceutical inorganic chemistry, along with communication skills. These five will be having theory and practical. So all the subjects is equally distributed, that is for 150 marks totally. Theory 100 marks, practical 50 marks. First subject is 150 marks. So you have internal exams and final exams. Internal exams will be having two sessionals, that is two internal exams and final one exams. So you have to attend both the internals and average will be taken. So you'll be writing 30 marks sessionals. Internal exams is for 30 marks. So that you'll be writing for two, that is sessional one and sessional two. So average of these two will be added. But you will be writing 30 marks, but it is calculated for 15. 30 divided by 2, 15. So for 15 marks will be calculating first sectional. Same thing, second sectional will be writing for 30 marks, that will be calculated for 15. And these two out of 15 marks will be taking average. So this average marks will be sent for university as internal marks. Along with 15 marks, there is additional 10 marks for. Anyone knows what is that additional 10 marks?
Attendance.
Not only attendance.
Student-teacher interaction.
Student-teacher interaction.
Assignment.
Assignment. Yes, class test, discussion. So for each, it is divided. The marks is divided. For attendance, it is 4 marks. For assignment, class test, group discussion, 3 marks. Student-teacher interaction, 3 marks. 3 plus 3 plus 4, totally 10 marks. So this 10 marks will be added to your 15 marks. 15 plus how much you get out of 10, that will be added. So total 25 marks. So this 25 marks is internal marks. So final exam, how much you will be writing for? 75 marks, theory.
75.
Okay, 75, you have to score there in final exam. So this 25 will be added to that. So totally it will become 75 plus 25, 100 for theory. Similarly for practical also, we have same two sessions and one exam. Sectional marks will be for 50 marks. Vajit, I'm going to remove you if you are not muting yourself. So practical also, similarly, you'll be writing two sessionals for 40 marks. That 40 marks, one sessional will be divided by 4, will be calculated for 10 marks. You'll be writing two sessionals, 10 marks, who will be taken out of 10, how much will be scored, along with that, plus 5 marks. So that 10 plus 10 average is done, and along with that 5 marks will be added. That 5 marks is again for your attendance 2 marks, record 2 marks, and your behavior with the teacher also 1 marks. Totally 5 marks for practical, 10 plus 5, 15 marks, and for final exam you'll be writing for 35 marks. So 35 plus 15, it will be 50 marks. So for all the subjects it is same. For all the 4 subjects, that is human anatomy and physiology, pharmaceutics, pharmaceutical analysis, and pharmaceutical inorganic chemistry. 4 subjects, the sessional exam and the marks is all same. So today we'll discuss about our subject, that is pharmaceutical analysis. So have you heard about pharmaceutical term, pharmaceutical word? What do you mean by pharma? What do you mean by pharma?
Medicine.
Medicine.
Related to pharma? It's derived from pharmacon. Pharmacon meaning drug. So pharmaceutical is drug related. Analysis means? What do you mean by analysis?
Purification, determination, or
analysis means you are going to analyze the compound. Either two ways. There are two ways of analysis. One is by qualitative analysis and the other is by quantitative analysis. Qualitative analysis is nothing but identification, whereas quantitative means you are going to find out the amount. So this is the pharmaceutical analysis. So what you'll be mainly studying in pharmaceutical analysis, you're going to find study how the drugs are analyzed, mainly qualitative and quantitative analysis. So what is the scope of the subject? The pharmaceutical analysis course deals with the fundamentals of analytical chemistry and principles of electrochemical analysis of the drugs. So the main course of pharmaceutical analysis deals with analytical chemistry as well as electrochemical analysis of drug. So objectives of the subject. So what you'll be studying upon this first sem after completing studying the pharmaceutical analysis subject. So what you'll gain the knowledge. First one, you'll be understanding the principles of volumetric and electrochemical analysis. So we'll be studying different types of volumetric analysis as well as electrochemical analysis, and also carry out various volumetric and electrochemical titrations. In practicals, you'll be doing various volumetric titrations, and you'll also gain the knowledge of analytical skills. So what is the course content? So your all the subjects contains 5 units. So whichever subject you take, it will be divided into 5 units. So we'll see unit 1. So in pharmaceutical analysis, under unit 1, you have to study these topics. That is pharmaceutical analysis. What is the definition and scope of pharmaceutical analysis? Then different techniques of analysis, methods of expressing concentration, primary and secondary standards, preparation and standardization of various molar and normal solutions. So what are the solutions, various molar and normal solutions you need to prepare and standardize, like oxalic acid, sodium hydroxide, hydrochloric acid, sodium thiosulfate, sulfuric acid, potassium permanganate, and stearic ammonium sulfate. So these compounds you need to prepare and carry out the standardization, and also you should know how to prepare different concentrations, like different strengths of normal and molar solutions. Next, under the same unit, you need to study what do you mean by errors, sources of errors, types of errors, methods of minimizing errors, what do you mean by accuracy, precision, and different significant figures. And also you'll be studying little about the pharmacopoeia, sources of impurities in medicinal agents, and limit test. Actually, this is removed because this you'll be studying in pharmaceutical inorganic chemistry in detail. So here we'll be just giving the brief note about what do you mean by pharmacopoeia, what are impurities, what are the sources of impurities, and what do you mean by limit test, what are the different types of limit tests. Second is unit 2. This is very important for your exams and as well as sessionals. There is a definite question from this chapter or unit. So here we have 2 chapters, you can say. The first one is acid-based titration, and the second is non-aqueous titration. So acid-based titration, what do you mean by acid and base? According to different theories, you need to study. Then what is the theory of acid-base indicators, classification of acid-based titrations, and theory involved in titrations of different acids and bases, like strong acid versus strong base, strong acid versus weak base, strong base versus weak acid, like that. Different combinations we need to study, and also we have to plot neutralization curves for different titrations. Second chapter is non-aqueous titration. Here also you should study principle, procedure, what are the different types of solvents used for non-aqueous titrations, what do you mean by stoichiometry and alkalimetry titration, and estimation of sodium benzoate and ephedrine hydrochloride. These are the drug compounds which you are going to find out or estimate. You are going to carry out analysis of this compound. Estimation is analysis. Next is unit 3. So unit 3, you are going to study again 3 chapters. The first one is precipitation titration. So under precipitation titration, we have different methods like Mohr's method, Ohlhart's method, modified Ohlhart's methods, Fagen's method, and you have to find out estimation of sodium chloride by precipitation titration. So these experiments you'll be doing in practical as well. Once the college reopens, when we start offline classes, practicals will be done. So next, complexometric titration. So here you need to study what is complexometric titration, its principle, classification, what do you mean by metal ion indicators, masking and demasking agents, estimation of magnesium sulfate and calcium gluconate by complexometric titration. Next is gravimetry. So gravimetry, here you need to study principle and steps involved in gravimetric analysis, purity of the precipitate, co-precipitation and post-precipitation, estimation of barium sulfate by gravimetric analysis. And also you need to study just a basic principle, methods and application of diazotization titration. Next is unit 4. So this is also an important topic, redox titrations. So in redox titrations, you need to study the concepts of oxidation and reduction, types of redox titrations along with their principles and applications like serimetry, iodimetry, iodometry, bromatometry, dichrometry, titration with potassium iodate. These are all comes under redox titrations, all you need to study. Next is unit 5. So from unit 2 to unit 4, it is titrimetric analysis. From unit 5, that is last unit, is about electrochemical methods of analysis. So what do you mean by electrochemical methods? Anyone, what do you mean by electrochemical method?
Using of electrodes.
Using of electrodes analysis.
Only electrodes?
Measuring current or potential.
And electrolytic solution, voltmeter.
Yes. Using different electrical properties. Example of electrical cell. Like example.
Charges.
Yes. Galvanic cell. Yes. Any method you know, electrochemical method of analysis, have you heard?
Salt bridge,
potentiometry, conductometry,
Kolbe electrolysis,
polarography. So these are the some electrochemical methods of analysis which you are going to study. So conductometry, introduction to conductometry, definition, its principle, what do you mean by conductivity cell, what do you mean by conductometric titrations and its applications. Next, potentiometry, electrochemical cell, construction and working of reference electrodes like standard hydrogen electrode, silver chloride electrode and calomel electrode, and indicator electrodes like metal electrodes and glass electrodes. And also you are going to study different methods to determine the endpoint by potentiometric titration and what are its applications. The last is polarography. What do you mean by polarography? What is its principle? What do you mean by Ilkovic equation? Construction and working of dropping mercury electrode and rotating platinum electrode and its applications. So these are the chapters or units which you need to study in pharmaceutical analysis. So is that clear about this subject?
Yes, ma'am.
And this 5 units, yes, ma'am. That is 2 units and 2.5 units. First 2.5 units will be for first sessional, and the remaining 2.5 units for the second sessional. So what are the unit 1? What comes under unit 1? Anyone remembers anything? Unit 1 is about
pharmaceutical analysis, under that the definition, the scope, the techniques, preparation of various types of solutions and all.
Yes, that is your.
And then errors and pharmacopoeia is also there under that.
Unit 1. So this unit 1 complete will be there for your first session. Second unit?
Non-aqueous titration.
Yes, good. Unit 3?
Basic principles and applications of trials titrate.
Complexometric titration.
Complexometric.
Gravimetric application of diazepam.
Complexometric and application of first session. Gravimetric diastization will second session. Unit 4.
Redox reaction.
Principles and applications of redox titrations.
Yes. And last, unit 5.
Hello.
Yeah, exercise in Rakana.
Guys, ma'am is offline. What happened?
So, the definition of pharmaceutical analysis, anyone knows?
Quantitative and qualitative analysis of medicine.
Qualitative and quantitative analysis of medicine is called pharmaceutical analysis.
Yes, ma'am.
Sure.
Good. Good.
Qualitative and qualitative analysis of drugs and medicines are called as.
Good. So I'll tell the definition. The pharmaceutical analysis is a branch of chemistry which involves the series of process for the identification, determination, quantitation, and purification of a substance. This is the actual definition of pharmaceutical analysis. So it is a branch of chemistry which involves the series of process like identification, determination, quantitation and purification of a substance. This is mainly used for separation of the components from the mixture and for the determination of the structure of the compounds. For both we can use pharmaceutical analysis. So there are two main types of chemical analysis, that is qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis. Qualitative analysis means identification. Quantitative analysis means estimation. So can anyone tell the definition now?
Qualitative analysis is a branch of chemistry. It deals with
qualitative analysis is not pharmaceutical analysis.
It is a branch of chemistry which involves in the identification, determination, quantification.
It is a process. In what series of process for?
Identification, determination, quantification.
And? Purification. Identification, determination, quantitation and purification of a substance. So this is mainly used for separation of the components from the mixture. So when you want to separate one component from a mixture of components, pharmaceutical analysis is used. And you can also determine the structure of the compound. So what do you mean by structure? What do you mean by structure of the compound?
Ma'am, how many bonds or electrons or lone pair that's present in the molecule?
Especially when you say structure, that is what are the molecules present, like how many carbon atoms, how many hydrogens, how many oxygen, like molecular formula of the compound is the structure of the compound. So there are two main types of chemical analysis, that is qualitative and quantitative. Qualitative is nothing but
identification.
Quantitative means
estimation.
So identification means in a mixture of compound, you need to find out one compound which is present. So that is means you have to identify whether the compound is present or not. Like that is qualitative. Quantitative means estimation. Estimation means finding out the amount. If that compound is present in the mixture, for how much quantity it is present, how many mg is present, how many grams is present, we need to find out amount. That is called quantitative or estimation. So qualitative analysis identification is performed to establish composition of natural as well as synthetic substances. For both natural and synthetic substances, we can use this qualitative analysis. These tests are performed to indicate whether the substance or compound is present in the sample or not. So whether this compound, given compound, is present in the given sample or not, we need to find out. So that is qualitative analysis. So various qualitative tests like detection of evolved gas, formation of precipitates, limit tests, color change reactions, melting point and boiling point tests, these are all comes under as qualitative tests. So the first priority of any analyst is to identify the sample. First you should know, right, what is the sample. Then qualitative analysis include identification of sample, that what kind of chemical moieties are present, like structure elicitation and molecular weight determination of molecule present in the sample. So these all comes under qualitative analysis. Next is quantitative. Quantitative means estimation, finding out amount. So Quantitative analysis, analytical techniques are mainly used to quantify any compound or substance in the given sample. So in the given sample, what is the amount of substance present? You are going to find out. That is the qualitative. Quantitative is how much quantity of substance is present. So this involves estimation of amount or weight or concentration of constituent present in the given sample. So in your 10 plus 2 or intermediate 12th standard, have you studied volumetric analysis or titrimetric methods?
Yes, ma'am.
So what type of titrations have you carried out? Anyone remember?
Potassium permanganate, ma'am. Experiment. Titration.
Potassium permanganate
comes to compound.
Potassium permanganate.
Permanganate oxidizing agent. Carried out is analysis comes under qualitative analysis or quantitative analysis?
Qualitative analysis.
You can't find out the amounts. Volumetric or titrimetric methods is a both qualitative and quantitative analytical method. So where you can identify as well as estimate the amount. So all these acid-based, non-aqueous, redox, complexometry, precipitation titrations, all comes under titrimetric methods of analysis. Will you take down the definition, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And book for this analysis. Take down the pharmaceutical. The pharmaceutical analysis is a branch of chemistry Pharmaceutical analysis is a branch of chemistry, comma, which involves the series of which involves the series of process for which involves the series of process for the identification, comma, determination comma, quantitation and purification of a substance full stop. This is mainly used for the determination of separation of the components from the mixture and for the determination of the structure of the compounds. This is mainly used for the separation of the component from the mixture and for the determination of the structure of the compounds. Types. There are two main types of chemical analysis. First one, qualitative analysis, in bracket, identification. Second, quantitative analysis, in bracket, estimation. Next heading, qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis is performed to establish composition of natural or synthetic substances. Next point, these tests are performed to indicate whether the substance or compound is present in the sample or not. So, example for various qualitative tests. Examples are detection of evolved gas, formation of precipitates, limit test, color change reactions, melting point and boiling point test, etc. finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
The first priority of any analyst is to identify the sample. So first preference is qualitative analysis. So this qualitative analysis includes identification of sample, that what kind of chemical moieties are present, like structure, elucidation, and molecular weight, determination of molecules present in the sample. Finished?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Quantitative analysis, that is estimation. Quantitative analytical techniques are mainly used to quantify any compound or substance in the sample. So you're finding out the amount, how much amount of compound or substance present in the given sample. That is nothing but quantitative estimation. So this involves estimation of amount or weight or concentration of constituents present in a sample. Finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
good. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So, did you understand what is pharmaceutical analysis, definition, types?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You have doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. So you have received timetable, right?
Ma'am, you sent this PPT in WhatsApp group, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Definitely, I'll send. Today, I have done only. Still, we need to complete. After completing, I'll send the PPT at a time. That's why I told you to copy the definition so that you can study. When we'll have our next class?
Yes, ma'am.
Tomorrow, I think.
Tomorrow we have again?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What time?
12 to 12:50.
So weekly 3 hours we have. Tuesday, first hour, Wednesday, third hour, and Friday, third hour. So 3 days. So next class is communication skills. Today, ma'am will be coming through Zoom. So you have to log in that link. So Zoom and GoToMeeting, I think, no problems. You can choose both the apps, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then remedial 1 minute.
What about the...
What's the name?
So Tuesday, you're almost free, only two classes, pharmaceutical analysis and communication skills. Only for them who are not opted for biology and maths, they have additional class, that is 130 to 220 remedial maths of biology. So till now I had sent in the group, so who are attending remedial maths and remedial biology classes, so only those, any other included, so anyone who has not studied maths or biology, nobody is there. Don't come at the last moment that we have not studied. So please look into that, and now only you start attending the class. And you know that GoToMeeting attendance, how it will be taken. So how many minutes in the class also will be recorded. Mute yourself, Vishwajit. So go to meeting. Your time in and time out also will be recorded. If you are coming to class late and you are not attending the classes properly, everything will be recorded. So be careful. You try to log in before 5 minutes of the class. So if suppose 10 o'clock the class is, try to log in by 9:55 and be ready. And don't leave the meeting in between. Attendance is compulsory. Strict actions are followed. Minimum 80% attendance is mandatory for writing the sessionals as well as final exam. If you have less than 80%, they are not going to allow you to write the sessionals and final exams. So any doubts you can ask last 2 minutes.
Ma'am, what about the books?
Books. So if you are local, like that is Bangalore, if you are staying in Bangalore, the college is open Monday to Saturday, 9 to 4 o'clock Monday to Friday, 9 to 1 Saturday. You can come at any time, get your fees receipt, take an ID card from the library. From library, the books are issued. So you can take the books for 15 days or 1 week. I think 3 books they will be issuing. You can take the book, study, return it, exchange it for every 10 or 15 days. Most of the books are available in the library. Please use that books only. No need to go for buying the books. If you wish, like, no, I want my own books, means we can refer that. If you wish, like, yes, we need a private book, we need to purchase, means that is your wish.
Ma'am, author name for this subject, ma'am?
Actually, this pharmaceutical analysis, we are using 3 to 4 different books. Not only one book. For like chapter 1, we have different book. For chapter 2, it is different book. So for this chapter 1, that is introduction to pharmaceutical analysis, we have pharmaceutical analysis books, various books. Now I am referring the inorganic chemistry book called Chatwal. So in this inorganic chemistry by Chatwal, we have the volumetric titrations, all volumetric analysis we have, like acid base, redox, precipitation, non-aqueous, everything we are getting in this book. So we are referring that book. So if you purchase this inorganic chemistry by Chatwal, it's helpful for both analysis as well as pharmaceutical inorganic chemistry. Both the subjects you can refer the same book. Not only for all the chapters I'm telling, it is for only few chapters. For other chapters you need to refer the other books.
Okay ma'am.
So since you are first year, we are trying to give some notes and all PPTs. So you can refer that along with the textbooks. Any doubts? Any queries?
Ma'am, for remedial biology and remedial math, will university exam conducted? University level, yes, or college level?
Level in the sense it will be conducted like same university exam but from the college only.
Okay ma'am.
That is also important, you can't skip.
Excuse me ma'am.
Yes
ma'am, is it okay to attend remedial maths and biology classes even if we have studied in 12th?
That's what I told. If you are attending, you need to write the test, sessionals, exams.
Okay,
it's
ma'am.
Okay. We have already created a separate group for remedial maths and remedial biology WhatsApp groups. So that's why I'm telling what are the names I have already posted in the group. Only those are there. You have to make ensure. Don't come at last moment and tell, ma'am, we have not studied. Please make sure now only confirm that. Only these, I think, five are there for biology, maths, and four are there for biology. How much? Two, three. Yes, four for maths, four for biology, and five for maths, I think. Only these many. Most of you have studied maths and biology, I hope. Okay, it's 10:53. We'll meet tomorrow class at 12 o'clock. All of you take care. Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you. Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.